So here we're going to factor completely x cubed minus 2x squared minus 16x plus 32. So whenever you have four terms like what you have here and you have to factor, I would recommend factoring by grouping. So we're going to take a look at what factoring by grouping is. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to actually group my first two terms. So my x cubed minus 2x squared. And then I'm going to factor my second two terms. My negative 16x plus 32. So let's take a look at the first two terms. And let's take out the GCF. So my GCF for my first two terms is x squared, because that is the largest value I can take out of both terms. And that's going to leave me with x minus 2. Okay? Now I'm going to take a look at my second two terms, my negative 16x plus 32. And my GCF for my second two terms is going to be, looks like it's going to be 16. Now I have the option of taking out a negative 16 or a positive 16 for my GCF. If I were to take out this negative, then that would mean inside the parentheses, I'm going to be left with a negative here. And if I take out a positive 16, that means that this term is still going to be negative, and then this term is still going to be positive. So since I want what's inside to match what I have over here, I'm going to take out my negative 16. And that's going to leave me inside with x minus 2. Now I'm going to take out my GCF from my entire situation here, because now I only have one, two terms. Okay? So my GCF for these two terms is going to be x minus 2, because that is the greatest common factor that this term and this term have in common. When I take out my x minus 2 from this term, I'm left with x squared. And when I take out my x minus 2 from this term, I'm left with negative 16. So that's how you factor by grouping. But we're not done. And we're not done because we just so happen to have what's called a difference of squares right here. A difference of squares is when you have two squares and then you have a subtraction sign in between them, which is exactly what we have here. We have x times x, and then over here, although it doesn't look like it, 16 can also be written as 4 times 4, so 4 squared. So whenever you have a difference of squares, that can be factored out or broken down into a plus b and a minus b. Okay? So my a here is going to be x, and my b here is going to be 4. So I'm going to rewrite this using this little formula, and I'm going to write x plus 4 and x minus 4. And then I'm going to bring down my x minus 2. Now we can't simplify that or factor that even further. So we have factored it completely, and our answer is x minus 2 times x plus 4 times x minus 4.